You're watching another Nerd Stalker interview.
Okay, we're live. Welcome to another Nerd Stalker interview. Good morning. This is Greg Vlory, aka Social Greg on Twitter for the Nerd Stalker Media Network. Today we talk with Tim Sinclair. CEO of Ringr. Ringr allows you to record a conversation with anyone, anywhere in the world and on any device and have it sound like you're in the same room. And what we're going to do, pretty unique here on Nerdstalker, we're actually going to record it on his application through my Android phone. And it's on right now with Tim. And I'm actually going to post-produce that and use that audio in Final Cut Pro with this broadcast, with the final version of this. So whatever you hear here on YouTube is in the Google version. And actually, it'd be kind of cool if we could actually compare an overlay. So anyway, good morning, Tim. Thanks for joining us here, Nerdstalker Live from Champaign, Illinois, right?
Yeah, good morning, Greg. I appreciate you you having me on, and we've sort of hacked our way into this, but it will be fun to do and to see the two back and forth together.
No, this is good. Well, anyway, tell me about, some of your background and how, the idea you had to start Ringr.
Well, I got into radio about 18 years ago, so I've worked all over the country hosting radio shows, and that's been my life, in the production room and on the air, and really developed a love for interviews, but a hatred for them as well, because they all sounded terrible. Nobody you want to talk to is ever in the same city. You know, they're always somewhere else in the world, and so you got to somehow get them on the air with you, and we've always done it through the phone. And they all sound awful. I often compare it to Neil Armstrong on the moon. It sounds exactly like that. And that was 45 years ago. And you go, how have we not figured out a way to make this sound better? And so I went about trying to create a way that we could connect with someone, record that conversation using the device that everybody already has, no expensive equipment, no crazy software, record the conversation, put it together again on the backside, and have it sound like we're sitting across the table having a conversation.
Wow, that's incredible. So when did you get this idea, and how long did it take to implement this?
It was a couple of years ago, maybe 3 years ago now, that I first had the idea. An artist that we played on the radio station where I worked was a friend of mine, but lived in Nashville, and I wanted to use some audio from him. And so I emailed him, and I said, Dave, I'm going to send you some questions in this email. Open up voice memos on your phone, record the answers, and then email it to me. See if it'll sound better than a regular phone interview. And he did, and it sounded great. And I went, if a phone with its little mic on the end and its internal recorder can sound this good with a little post-production and a little creativity, what if we could talk and both of our phones could record in a live environment? How would that look? And really, that sort of is what took me down the path of, okay, well, let's have his phone record him. Let's have my phone record me. Then we'll put those together on the backside. And if we can figure out a way to make those sync, the finished file is going to sound amazing. And that's what Ringr is.
Yeah, that, is incredible to me. At first, the people were in one of your classes at the accelerator program at Ocean kind of introduced us, right?
Yeah.
And at first I thought, oh, is this just another WhatsApp app? But then I started thinking about it, and then, oh, no. And then actually, well, it'll benefit me, right? So I started thinking about this, like, oh, this is interesting. And I just that week recorded an interview with a guy in Austria creating, he's from like AKG, right? Right. High quality stuff. Right. So he created this Bluetooth hardware thing on Indiegogo. Right. And then I thought, oh, that's kind of cool. Then I came across yours and I thought, well, this is even better.
Yeah. Well, so, it's been fun to see people's eyes kind of get real big and go, oh man, if we could do that, That would be amazing. And man, you play the audio back, and I think everybody, in the middle of it right now, we're hearing typical voice over IP audio. We've created our own voice over IP network, like a Skype or FaceTime. Okay. And so it sounds pretty much like you would normally hear a Skype or FaceTime call, which is good. It's better than phone. But then when you hear what it actually sounds like after it's been recorded, we're not recording any of the transmission. We're just using a mic on my end and a mic on your end to record what's actually happening. And that sounds tremendously better. And we're not too far away, just a couple of months away, from supporting external mics. So now you'll be able to plug in a lightning port mic to your device. And now it sounds studio quality all the time. And we're really excited about that.
So this isn't just for interviews, right, Tim? I mean, musicians could even collaborate a little bit, right?
In theory, yeah. The syncing, I mean, it syncs almost perfectly every time. I mean, it's really, really close. And for conversation, it's perfect. For music, you could technically all play together. The adjustments after the fact in post-production might have to be a little bit more significant than it is for a conversation, but we give you every track individually. So when we go to conference calling, for example, which will happen later this year, it won't just be one-to-one, it could be four or five or six people, you would get all six of those tracks individually and the mix down. So you could take all six and move them around slightly if you needed to. And you know, I think the possibilities with that are endless.
Oh, absolutely. It just hit me when I was kind of thinking about this whole thing about, you know, just recently getting a lot of audio type interviews, and, you know, it just hit me about musicians just now, but I, you know, in 2 years, technology must have always helped you, right? Or has it?
Yeah. I honestly think why 2 or 3 years ago when I started floating this idea to people, they all told me no, is because the technology wasn't quite there yet. We're asking phones and tablets to do a lot. They have to connect on voice over IP and send a low quality audio back and forth that way. They also have to record in high quality at the same time, that same audio stream on its own end, and then upload that after the fact. And so that, you know, for a typical phone 2 or 3 years ago, that was a significant ask. And you know, Wi-Fi networks and 3 and 4G networks and LTE, they weren't as strong. So your access to those and your consistency with those was lower. But now we've found that 3G, 4G, LTE, Wi-Fi, you can record a conversation. We literally had two people, I believe in California, they were co-hosts of a podcast together, and they recorded their podcast in separate cars on their way home from work because they could. And so we've really found that that technology increase and the speed increases in both the phones and the networks really allowed us to be able to make this happen.
So let's, you know, shift to some of the technology stuff. You had mentioned offline that, you know, you have some, IP protecting some of this stuff. So, I mean, that's gold, man. So tell us a little bit about that.
Yeah, we're still in the process of it. Yeah. Okay. We filed quite a while. Yeah, that's all right. It's been filed. And we did searches and we looked through all the potential people that might be in our space or that we might be in their space, and seemed to find a fairly good hole where we can live of white space that nobody's in at the moment. And the goal is to be able to not only protect what Ringr does now, but to do the exact same thing with video, and to do the exact same thing with conference calling. So again, instead of just a one-to-one audio, you could do one-to-one video, and then in both the audio and video spaces, we can layer not just two, but 4, 6, 8, or 10 people at the same time.
I mean, this is really cool because, like, you can see what, you know, on our screen here, you know, yeah, I have this big ass 1-inch condenser mic that just gives my voice a little bit warmer, but, you know, but that's a tone that's really kind of soothing in a way, if you think about it, you know, that type of voice. And if your service could give that same type of voice, man, that's just awesome. And, you know, I wanted to ask you, you know, a couple more questions about, you know, you don't need a special mic. It just uses the mic through your phone, right? So any phone will work, right? Android or iOS, right?
Correct. And like you see, I'm using the white.